everyone. In today's video, I have a city update for you. I got some work done on the city. I'm pretty happy with what I've done so far. So I'll meet you over in the city. Welcome to my channel, FabBlondies Bricks, where my builds are 99% Lego and 1% cat hair. So let's head over to the city and see the progress that I've made. Today, I'm gonna be working on the city, and I did do a little bit of work off camera on the mountain, basically to start evening out the top because there is a one brick height difference, as you can see right here. So that was something I did start to work on a little bit, but not too much. But this is something that I'm gonna be working on a little bit later. Today, what I'm going to work on is going to be right here. I'm going to work on the lake that will be based off of the Expecto Patronum set that I have here. I do have the Dementor somewhere. I'm just not 100% sure where it is right now, but I do want to recreate a little bit of that scene right here. So that is what I am going to be working on today. Now here is the project bin for the lake. So over here on this side, you can see that I have lots of different color blue plates. I did get a bunch in an order that I forgot to do a haul video for, but now I have all the correct colors. And over here on this side, I have all of my trans clear plates that I'm going to use for the lake also. So together, this should make a pretty fantastic lake. And over here, you can see that I have moved all of my Lego Harry Potter castles. This is everything from 2018 to 2020, and then 2021 to 2022, except for the two that were released in June, but I do have those coming very shortly. But I did move everything from the dining room downstairs up to my room. So I have laid down the first layer of the lake, and I laid down these dark blue plates. So this is going to be the maximum size of the lake. It is 32 by 24 studs, and there's going to be multiple layers to the lake. So now on to the next layer. If you're enjoying this video so far, why don't you go ahead and give that like button a little pounce? And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the channel and clicking that notification bell. Everything that you do will help the channel grow, and it'll make little Penelope here very happy. If you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments below. I read all of your comments and I do respond to all of them. So let's get back to the city and see the rest of my progress that I made. So here is the second layer, and I am finished with it. You can see that I did use all different kinds of plates because I want to add lots of different depth and dimension to it. And I used these blue plates, and then the center has these 1x2 dark blue transparent plates. So I used those in the center, and I think that's gonna add a lot of depth to the lake and just make it more interesting. So let me get started on this third layer. Okay, so here is the third layer of the lake. Now I did need to order some pieces for the lake, so I'm gonna stop work on this until I get my pieces in. So next up, I am going to work on getting some more detail on the mountain and evening the top, I mean, so that it is going to be more straight. And then I'm also going to work on the support on the inside to hold Hogsmeade Village. So I will check in with you in a little bit. So here is the corner of the mountain. Right here, you can see I got a lot of detail work done. I did a lot of detail work first before I did any of the core. I am going to be putting some bricks down here in front of the mountain also to even out the terrain. So I'll be doing that. I haven't done anything with the inside yet to put any of the support in because I was really just focused on getting this detail done because I wanted to get this side of the mountain done. So now that that is done, I will go and work on other parts of the project. And here you can see what the corner of the mountain looks like once it is in place, and can see a huge difference between what I have finished and what I still need to finish. So what I am going to do now, I actually need more pieces for doing the rest of this on the front. I'm going to wait a little bit to do the inside for the support, but I am going to work on laying brick around the lake here and making sure that I put it all the way back to the back of the mountain so that this whole area right through here should be bricked and ready for landscape. Okay, so here is what I have done. I actually ran out of green bricks sooner than I thought I would. I know it doesn't really matter what color I have right here because I'm going to have plates going on top of these, but it does matter to me. So I need to make sure that I order some more green bricks. And then also, let me show it to you here along the front. I'm going to have the dark tan 2x4s along the front edge that's going to be exposed, and that will just be to represent, like, you know, the dirt that's underneath the grass. And then again, there's my lake waiting on parts for that, but it looks like I'm going to need to order some more parts, so we are going to call it a day. Let me know in the comments below what you thought of the progress that I've made. If you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.